has always been this competition between us, and the British press is part in that, right? They pitch the Waleses, right, which Kate and William and I are now, against the Sussexes, me and my wife. William and I made a pact, made a deal that no matter what, we would never let our officers fight against each other.
You think he broke that pact?
The people that he employed broke that pact.
Harry's tell-all tour keeps rolling as he spilled the beans to Good Morning America.
I probably would have done less drugs. I would have probably drunk less, partied less. For me, it was kind of either trying to find a feeling or numb a feeling. But my military service literally saved me.
He'll air more dirty laundry with Stephen Colbert tomorrow.
It's either a gripping tell-all about the royal family or a book of handy bowling tips.
He kept repeating the same things. It was the leaks and his obsession with the British press.
I know, she would say that, but after Oprah, the podcast, the Netflix series, and now the memoir, some of Harry's complaints are starting to ring a little hollow.
You have railed against invasions of your privacy all your life, but the accusation will be, here are you invading the privacy of your most nearest and dearest without permission. That'll be the accusation, right?
That'll be the accusation from the people that don't understand or haven't or don't want to believe that my family have been briefing the press solidly for well over a decade. None of this is intentionally to harm anyone in my family, but I certainly feel as though we never needed to be here.
But the portrait of your brother is harmful to him.
I can't understand why Charles hasn't said nothing yet. Yeah, but it's just ridiculous.
For their part, the royal family's never complain, never explain strategy seems to be working.
The way they've gone about things is quite disrespectful.
Now that the things are getting a little dirty, I'm a little on the side of not supporting them so much.
So while Harry has got a book to sell, is all publicity really good publicity?
Cross to Blighty and find out. Latika Bourke joins us from the heart of the empire. Latika, how are people reacting to Harry's media blitz over there?
Look, Prince Harry is pretty much number one villain in the UK, and I think it's worth stepping back and remembering just how loved he used to be. When I moved here 7 years ago, he was the darling of the royal family in the public's eye. He was Diana's boy who'd had a partying lifestyle. People understood that he'd had a very difficult upbringing and had suffered trauma, an unimaginable degree of trauma that most people felt deep sympathy for. But they saw him go and serve in Afghanistan, found the Invictus Games, and really thought this guy was proving himself as someone with substance and someone with a lot to give back to society. But my, how that has changed. He has fallen from that dais and is now pretty much loathed, not universally. There's still a lot of sympathy for his experiences growing up and the trauma that he describes about the loss of his mother in 1997. But there's also a lot of anger at just the degree of overshare and the hypocrisy of complaining about the invasions of his own privacy while leaking really unnecessary details about his own father and brother.
Yeah, Harry's complaints around the media manipulation, they might be valid, but the tell-all interviews, do you think that's pushing the public sentiment back towards the Windsors and sort of supporting the royal family?
Yeah, it might surprise you to learn we ran a poll just a couple of days ago and I was really surprised by these findings. But Prince William is actually the most favourite royal in the UK. They really do like him. Now, I thought that Prince William was a bit of a distant character, a bit of an aloof one. But Harry really ratting out on his brother, who is just trying to do his best in the role that he's also been born into. And don't forget, Prince William also lost his mother under the same traumatic circumstances that Harry did. They see somebody really trying to carry out his job to the best of his ability, and Harry really trying to settle some scores, some of which seem a little unremarkable, you know, squabbling over the size of bedrooms and things like this. Harry does seem to have brought his younger brother resentment to this book and this narrative. And I think a lot of people are going to think that's a bit beyond what justifies public complaint.
Latika, the Sussexes have now told their story and sold some books and promoted their Netflix series, but they've also seemingly in doing so burned their bridges. What do you think their long game is?
Well, not necessarily burn their bridges in the United States, and that's really the key here. If they're successful in landing this narrative across the Atlantic, then that's a big win for them. They can continue to build their public image. There's lots of speculation that Meghan herself might run for politics. We can expect to see those two really upping their game if this is somewhat of a success. In Britain, of course, it's a very different story. You're going to find a lot of Harry's old friends just won't talk to him because they don't know if they can be trusted in terms of the Sussexes, and if their private conversations might be leaked in a way that Harry has clearly gone forth and done with this book and with his interviews. So on this side of the world, it's pretty hard to see Harry and Meghan really having any sort of way back into public life and the royal family here. But in America, who knows?
Latika, thanks so much for speaking to us tonight. It's always a pleasure.
Fascinating, isn't it, when you look at that? And I know, you know, we all love our 15th century English history. But you look back at Henry VIII and, you know, the courtiers there and the role they played in bringing down kings and monarchies and promoting people. And I don't think much has changed. Mm. It's less about bringing down, I guess, the king or the queen, but it's more about the different courts sort of playing this PR game. It's fascinating to watch, and I don't think the family really has much control over it.
That's a really interesting point, because he's saying my family leaked against me, but you notice in the questions where you say, oh, do you say your brother broke that pact? Mm. He says, well, he employed people who did. So he's kind of distancing his direct family from it in one sentence, but in another, he's talking about his family as though they're active agents.
Yeah, 500 years along, actually, not much has changed.
Well, I think they could be going for, like, a new royal strategy for 2023. So, like, yes, you would still be, you know, king and queen, but they could be, like, in a media sense, bigger than anyone in the royals has ever been. So they would have a new kind of power that no one's ever had in the royal family.
President Meghan.
Oh,
my goodness.
So I never thought I would say this, but they just need to become more like the Kardashians, don't they?
Waleed, exactly.
Hey, don't groan. Actually, no, that groan was entirely fair enough, now that I think of it. But what I mean by that is their PR is really tight.
Mm. Totally.
There's nothing against, there's one voice, they're all on board, and there's someone who's in charge, I don't know who, but there's someone who's in charge of it, right? And the royals don't do that.
And people are consuming this in the same way they would consume any reality TV. Yeah. Like, there is actually no difference to it.
So, like Queen Kris Jenner is what you're saying.
I really don't want to be the face of that campaign.
That is what you're saying.